you like music like this? Or this? How about this? Well, of course you do, you rambunctious little pumpkin. That's why you're watching my utterly spiffing guide to light music. Episode 1, Harmony. First up, some plucky pizzicato. Pizzicato comes from the Italian, a pizzicato. This first example was composed by David Rose in 1942. It's titled Holiday for Strings. Wonderful, isn't it? The important thing to grasp here is the use of extended harmony. In basic harmony, one has the following notes: root, third, and fifth, major, or root, minor third, and fifth, minor. If that were a sandwich, it would look like this. Light music evolves out of the orchestral and jazz music that preceded it and employs sixths, sevenths, ninths, elevenths, and thirteenths, all of which can be sharpened or flattened. If that were a sandwich, it would look like this. Looking at the voicing, and one can see that the top violin part and cello part both perform the melody, but in different octaves. In close harmony in between, we have two more violin parts and a viola part. These harmony parts trace the shape of the melody, but pick out those delicious chord tones along the way. Combined with the bass part, we have a six-part harmony in the strings alone. I once got so carried away listening to this piece that I did this. I apologize to the ladies present. Example number 2, High Heels by Trevor, Duncan from 1950. The composer's real name was Leonard Charles Trebilco, and Trevor Duncan was a pseudonym. On my weekends in Soho, I also use the pseudonym Valerie Loveheart. Look out for the extended chords, but also chromatic chord changes and the use of substituted chords from outside of the key of E-flat major. Example 3, On a Spring Note by Sidney Torch from 1952. With Eastern European heritage, Sidney Torch's real name was Sidney Torchinsky. Funnily enough, I spent many years composing in Eastern Europe under the name
Alexey Balinsky.
First, we'll hear the pizzicato accompaniment, and then we'll hear it with the woodwind melody. Example 4, Melody on the Move by Clive Richardson from 1946. Clive didn't use any pseudonyms, otherwise I'd have a joke here. Real spoil sport, aren't you, Clive? First, we'll hear the string accompaniment, and then with the woodwind melody. next composer started life as Wally Stott, and then later became the composer Angela Morley, leading to the publication of the series Where's Wally? Angela was a huge talent who won multiple Emmy Awards and was nominated for an Oscar. The next piece is by her and is titled A Canadian in Mayfair. Again, the top violin and viola take the melody an octave apart, with the three other violin parts filling in the harmony in close voicing. Next, we move to luscious legato. Legato comes from the French.
Legato.
Creamy. We're back where we started with another excerpt from David Rose's Holiday for Strings. I once took some strings on holiday. The violas got very sunburned. Watch out for the close harmony and extended chords as shown on the score. The minor-major seventh chord appears twice and is worth noting. That's root, minor third, fifth, and major seventh. Next up, Lady in Love by Steve Breton. Who is in fact Trevor Duncan, who is in fact Leonard Charles Trebilco, a pseudonym within a pseudonym. He probably watched too much Scooby-Doo. Look out for the chromatic chord changes, the minor major seventh chord again, and the extended harmony. Example 3. Another section from A Canadian in Mayfair. Some quite remarkable eight-part harmony in just the strings alone. The full piece includes brass, woodwinds, and percussion, which we'll discuss in another episode. Example 4, Melody in the Sun by Alan Perry. Alan Perry was a pseudonym used by Ernest Tomlinson. In fact, I'm starting to wonder if there was actually just one light music composer who created an entire genre through the use of pseudonyms. Ernest was a masterful orchestrator and composer who won two Ivor Novellos and a Composer's Guild Award. He was also honored with an MBE for services to music. My greatest achievement is winning a bicycle pump in the village raffle. We're in A major, and watch out for the particularly tasty substitution of chord 7. It would normally be G-sharp half diminished. Ernest instead uses G9. It sounds like hot treacle poured on a waffle with three cherries on top. Last, but by no means least, an excerpt from Robert Farnon's 1955 delight, Portrait of a Flirt. Farnon was another giant of light music, picking up four Ivor Novellos and the Order of Canada. Check out the close voicing of six-part harmony in this excerpt. Thus concludes this episode of my Artly Spiffing Guide to Light Music. I've posted links to all these wonderful pieces of music in the description. If you've enjoyed it, please post a like to 17 Marmalade Crescent, London, L1123. Alternatively, use your typewriter to comment below. Pip, pip, play. chairs out, Miss Morley.